Okay, so you've got a formula, quadratic formula, 8 inches per mile squared. What is the distance for the half measure? Quadratic formula, guys, come on. 8 inches over a mile. What is it at half a mile? The distance of a
Except
mile is, according to the formula, 8 inches. The question for you is, what is that distance over the half mile? The answer is a number in inches. Do you know it?
This was Bev trying to make sense of 8 inches per mile squared with a group of people on Discord. So let's listen in. We'll make some comments and then we'll do some geometry.
So that number, that 8 inches, is a vertical distance, right?
Technically, no. That's something a flat earther might say.
I'm not a flat earther.
This vertical distance will actually be a longer path to the plane, although for the distances that we're talking about here, there's virtually no difference.
Yeah, so it's literally just the measured drop.
So come on, Bev, tell us how you work it out.
8 inches per mile squared. So we start off with the eight. The quadratic would make it two, wouldn't it? Quarter, it being a quadratic. Wouldn't a quarter of eight be two?
Well, he's got the right answer, and maybe I'm doing him a disservice, but there's a little part of me that thinks that he's divided 8 by 4 simply because, and for no other reason than the word quadratic has got quad in it, meaning 4 or fourth. Of course, halving the distance means you can divide the known drop height by 4, or we could do 1 half squared, which makes a quarter, and a quarter of 8 inches is 2 inches.
McToon says the 8 inches per mile squared formula is accurate.
Well, let's construct the geometry for both imperial and metric, and we'll ask GeoGebra to measure the drop at various points. First, we'll define a variable for the radius of planet Earth, and second is to create a very small part of its curved surface. Next up are three variables. C is a conversion for inches in a mile. S1 is a half a mile surface distance away, and S2 is a mile. The next step is to create a checkbox so that we can switch between imperial and metric. We'll come back to this in a minute. Here's our initial point A. Point B, that's half a mile away from A. Point C, and that's half a mile away from B. Now, checking this box will do a number of things at once. It will change the radius value to 6371 kilometers. This conversion number will change to a million millimeters in a kilometer. The distance from A to B will change to 100 meters. And the distance from B to C will also be 100 meters. Next, I want to create two tangential planes, one at A and one at B. There's very little point in leaving these visible as they're practically hugging the surface. So I'll leave them both hidden for now. Next, I want to write the line that will measure the drop at B from the plane that's tangent at A. I'm basically asking GeoGebra to find the closest point in that plane to point B and then return that distance in inches. Out of interest, I also want to measure the drop at point C from the plane that's tangent at B, and it shouldn't come as any surprise that this distance is the same as the previous result. Lastly, we want to get the drop over the full mile, so that's the distance from the plane that's tangent at A to point C. And we get a tad over 8 inches.
Let's
Meters,
say
but we would
it's
translate
2 inches
that
over a half mile. Well, if you add those two together, you end up with 4 inches. But if you start from one point and go the whole mile, you have 8 inches. So there's a difference of 4 inches, isn't there? That's pretty noticeable, right? As an impossible sort of measurement. It would go to show you how impossible it is to measure this thing. Because if you go twice as far, it isn't twice the drop, which is impossible. You get your brain gets fried when you see an impossibility. But you have to either have to work the impossibility out or just let it go and incorporate it into your model. But if you incorporate impossibilities into the framework that you're basing everything on, then you end up with a broken mind. It's impossible.
Here, Bev starts thinking linearly, you know, like a flat earther.
I'm not a flat earther.
But if he remembered Tis Globe...
Tis Globe!
He could leave his incredulity by the wayside.
Well, if that's measurable, the quarter mile would be measurable too.
Well, a quarter times a quarter is a 16th. Times that by 8, that's 8 over 16, or a half, so half an inch. Let's give it a go. Half an inch.
I mean, in a mile you've got 8 inches, but what have you got at 100 metres? 200 metres? You know, measurable distances, what have you got? Because you'd only end up with, like, let's say you get 1 millimetre drop over 100 metres. Well, 16 of them would give you 16 millimetres. That's not 8 inches. Like, you're missing a fair bit there, aren't you? You're not even really at an inch.
Well, I'm going to leave this one here. Seeing the way this geometry was constructed, I'm hoping Bev will no longer see this as an impossibility. Maybe, just maybe, he'll realise the error in his thought process.
Has to be a globe, right? Absolutely. How could it not be? Tis Globe!